In this episode, we'll travel the northern 19 miles of the Little Miami Scenic Trail from Xenia to Springfield, Ohio.
In Xenia, we'll stay at Victoria's Bed and Breakfast, see Xenia Station and the Galloway Cabin. At Yellow Springs, we'll visit Glen Helen Nature Preserve and Young's Jersey Dairy. And at Springfield, we'll visit the very unique Hartman's Rock Garden and end our ride at the beautiful Clark County Heritage Center.
Before we get out on the trail today, I want to tell you about where I stayed last night. I'm at Victoria's Bed and Breakfast, which is an old Eastlake Victorian home built in 1881. It's beautiful, and my gracious hosts, Carl and Carol Otzbach, welcomed us here to this beautiful place, and I'm eager to talk to you about the history behind this home and what you offer to the cyclists who can visit here and stay here. We're only four blocks from the trail and from Xenia Station. So tell me a little bit about what you offer to people who might want to stay here.
Well, we offer a very quiet atmosphere, an opportunity for them to congregate together. They can store their bicycles in the garage that we have here.
Oh, nice.
and stay, and they have the evening available to them. There's screened-in porch, there's porches outside. They can sit, congregate. We have games and things for them. We can set up tables, card tables, and they can relax and be together and talk about the trails that they've been on and what they're planning for the next day. We try to provide information on the trails, maps and things like that for them.
Yes, you've got a whole room of information. Well, you've got several. This house is huge, but you've even got a pool table upstairs.
Yep. Yeah, we provide it. They can go shoot pool for a little while if they like, and sit out on the screen and porch up in the royal suite and just relax.
You know, when you said peaceful enjoyment, I must say that after a day riding out and seeing all the sights and being out in the weather, it was so nice to come home to just this big, spacious, beautiful home. And it was so peaceful. It's just nice to just sit and relax.
For us, our philosophy's been, you come in a stranger, you leave a friend.
Yeah.
If you come back twice, you become family.
Tell me a little bit about, this home is so beautiful and so historical. Tell me some of the special details about the home.
There's all kinds of etched glass. There's stained glass windows.
Chandeliers.
That's right, the original chandeliers hanging from the ceilings.
Museum quality, it's artwork. And I've been to lots of museums where, you know, you get to walk through, but here you get to actually just stay and soak in the ambiance, the unique qualities of it.
True. And many of those museum homes that you get to tour aren't in nearly as good a condition as this one is. This is really beautiful. 12-foot ceilings, 10-foot doors, woodwork, curved, arched, all the locks, the detail.
Tooled brass work. Yeah.
So well maintained after all these years. No one came in and painted it. No one did really
harm to it. Or stripped it out. Right.
Yeah. Tell me about, you mentioned John Allen, the banker, who had this built. You've got his desk, right?
Yes, we have his desk.
That's that desk right over there.
Yeah. He sat out. It still has the ink stains in the wood. He actually signed underneath it. His signature's in the desk itself. So it's a very unique piece in that sense.
Well, we're very fortunate to get to stay here. Really, I thank you very much.
Here I am at Xenia Station. Xenia, Ohio was a big railroad town in its heyday. Now, though this building behind me was built in 1998, it's a replica of a station that sat here in the 1880s. Inside, there's a history museum, there are classrooms, really nice restrooms, and on top, there's this cool lookout. Now all the trails in Xenia come right to this point. They call this the hub.
Xenia Station sits on 7 acres of parkland. The grounds include a restored B&O caboose, a playground, picnic shelter, and plenty of parking. It makes a perfect gathering point for cycling groups. Xenia, spelled with an X, is Greek and means hospitality. And you'll find hospitality here. Xenia is known as the bicycle capital of the Midwest. Heading north, the Little Miami Scenic Trail takes us on sidewalks, giving us a feel for this town of 26,000. What's very striking about Xenia is its history of severe storms. This is Shawnee country, and the Shawnee referred to the area as the place of the devil wind. 20 tornadoes have been recorded here since 1884, and that's a lot for Ohio. In 1974, an F5 tornado blew straight through town, killing 34 people and destroying nearly half of the city. That day, Xenia lost 5 schools, 9 churches, 180 businesses, and rendered 10,000 people homeless. But the American spirit drives a town like this one to rebound in extraordinary ways. I found the folks of Xenia to be friendly and eager to share their town and their history.
I'm at Galloway Cabin. This is one of the oldest structures in Greene County. Originally built along the banks of the Little Miami River, it was moved here in 1965 as part of the Greene County's Historical Society's museum.
Built of oak, it features glass window panes and large fireplaces. That tornado I mentioned did some serious damage, but you can't tell it now. James Galloway, the original owner, was a Revolutionary War soldier from Kentucky and a friend of Daniel Boone's. After the war, Galloway found himself in western Ohio fighting the Indians. Tecumseh, the great Shawnee chief, was one of those Indians, and that's where the story gets interesting. Through those turbulent years, Tecumseh and Galloway ironically became great friends, and Galloway promised when he made peace with the Indians, he would move his family up here. Sure enough, in 1795, Tecumseh gave Galloway a tomahawk peace pipe, now on display at Fort Ancient. Galloway and his wife built the house in 1799. Riding through town, you can see we have access to all the hospitality that Xenia has to offer. Now back to Tecumseh. Riding this trail takes us right through his stomping grounds. He was born in Old Town, not far from here. It's also near where the Galloway Log House was originally built. Now we all know Tecumseh, the fearless Shawnee warrior. Volumes have been written about him. He spent his whole life defending his people's land from the invasion of white settlers. His unlikely friendship with James Galloway extended to Galloway's daughter, Rebecca. On Tecumseh's many visits to their house, she read to him and helped him perfect his English. This covered bridge is really pretty. It opened in 2014 to replace an old metal bridge. No, that bridge wasn't covered, but the builders knew this one would look good. This northern section of the Little Miami Scenic Trail is no different than the southern 56 miles. It's well-maintained pavement and very scenic. It's rural, but you're never very far from a store, an eatery, or a public restroom. We're getting close to Yellow Springs, home of Antioch College, founded in 1852.
Glen Helen Nature Preserve is a 1,000-acre nature reserve right along the bike trail. It's on the national list of natural landmarks. Funded totally by private donations, the reserve houses a nature center, trailside museum, a raptor center, a riding center, an outdoor education center, and more than 20 miles of day-use trails. In cooperation with Antioch College, which is right across the street, they host a variety of public programs and educational camps. The main feature here, of course, is the beautiful gorge, which encloses the Yellow Springs Creek. This creek flows into the Little Miami River. This place has it all. Limestone cliffs, waterfalls, 400-year-old trees, a unique pillar rock, and even a Hopewell Indian mound. I'm standing here in front of this spring, which is called the Yellow Spring, and this is where the town of Yellow Springs gets its name. There happens to be a lot of iron in the soil here.
And here is Yellow Springs. On the left is Peach's Grill, burgers galore, and 21 beers on tap. You'll want to stop at the train station for visitor information and public restrooms. And don't miss downtown. For such a tiny town of only a couple thousand people, it's really thriving with businesses. It's fun to ride around just to see what's going on. It's a colorful downtown with a variety of shops, art galleries, and restaurants. It looks like the perfect place to find unique items. Why, they even have a brewery. No bike ride is complete without a sugary treat along the way. Yes, I've heard it said, eat to ride, ride to eat.
Well, we've taken a little detour off the Little Miami Scenic Trail over to Young's Jersey Dairy. It's about a mile and a half outside of Yellow Springs and well worth the extra pedaling you'll do to get here. This place is family friendly, has a ton of stuff to do, and of course we can eat all kinds of goodies here. And I'm here with Destiny. Destiny's going to tell us about the myriad of things there are to do here at Young's Dairy. Destiny, so tell me first of all, what do you do here?
I work inside the store and I just help the customers that come in here.
So you grew up around here?
Yes, I came here as a kid with my family, and we always came and pet the goats. That was our favorite thing to do, was feed the goats. And then we would get ice cream afterwards.
Now, tell me some of the things there are for a family to do here.
Well, you can go to the batting cages, you can go play miniature golf, you can pet our goats, and it's our fall season right now, so we have things like the pumpkin patch and the corn maze.
I just saw a wagon load of people go behind you. So yep. Where were they headed?
We do have the wagons taking people to the pumpkin patch because it is down the property.
So tell me a little bit about these pumpkins. I understand you've got some kind of a thing going on during festival weekend.
Yeah, we have our fall festival, which already passed, and we have games that they can play. We have the pumpkin launch, and we have pumpkin bowling, things like that, where they play the games for free ice cream.
So the pumpkin launch, explain that.
Basically, you just take a pumpkin, launch it at your target, and try to make it in. No, how many tries it'll take you.
And you get free ice cream.
Yep.
All right. So this is really an agritourism, family-friendly place, talking about farm to table. What kinds of products do you have here?
We make our own ice cream, and then we also make our own cheese, which is a really big seller here. We use it on our burgers, and we also have our cheese curds, which is our best-selling side. It's our white cheddar, breaded and deep-fried, and they're really good.
Cheese, breaded, and deep-fried.
Yeah.
Now that sounds delectable. So most people have a sweet tooth. You've got the ice cream. What else do you have? I saw some baked goods in there.
Yeah, we also make our own bread. We make things like sweet potato bread and our pumpkin bread during the season. We have pumpkin donut holes, and we make all of our pies.
You have your own bakery here.
Yep, right in the back of the store.
And I know this is a working dairy, so you've got cows here, right? You literally
yep.
are using the milk from the cows to make what, your ice cream and your cheese?
That's a question we get a lot, if we use our milk for our ice cream, but we can't do that. We only have 40 dairy cows, and it would take about 40,000 for how much ice cream we sell. So we do only use our milk for our cheese.
Okay, so you've got 40 cows mm-hmm. making the cheese milk, but it would take 40,000 cows to make enough ice cream?
Yes, because we sell so much of it.
That's a lot of ice cream. So I imagine you probably get a lot of cyclists through here. Do you cater to them in any particular
yeah,
way?
Yeah, if you ride your bike in on a Wednesday, we have a deal we call Wheelin' Wednesdays. You can get 2 scoops for the price of one and whatever flavor you want.
Oh, no kidding. How very cool is that? All right, so they love cyclists just about a mile and a half outside of Yellow Springs here at Young's Dairy.
From State Route 68, where Young's Jersey Dairy is, to Springfield is about 9 miles. Springfield is a city of about 60,000 residents. It has a large art museum, many historical sites, and impressive churches. There's even a house built by Frank Lloyd Wright. Springfield is where 4-H, the National Organization for Boys and Girls Clubs, got started. And we all drive cars. I found out during the early 1900s, 10 different automobiles were being produced here. And at one time, Springfield was known as the City of Roses, because by 1919, there were 33 greenhouses producing more roses than any other city in the world. Springfield sits on the National Road, which is US 40. The National Road was the first federally funded interstate highway. It was authorized in 1806 under Thomas Jefferson and crosses 6 states, from Maryland to Illinois. Though we won't get to visit there on this trip, the Pennsylvania House Museum sits on the National Road only blocks from the end of this trail. The Pennsylvania House was a popular 26-room inn built in 1839.
Well, we're just a roll away from the Little Miami Scenic Trail here in Springfield, Ohio at the Hartman Rock Garden. And it's a really, really unique place. And we're fortunate enough to have with us one of the board members to tell us a little bit more in detail. Kevin Rose. Thank you so much for being with us.
Yeah,
we just have a few questions to ask you about this truly unique place.
Yeah, thank you for joining us here at the garden.
Yeah, we're happy to be here. So tell us some history here.
So the garden was started in March of 1932 by a gentleman named Ben Hartman. He was an out-of-work molder at a local factory, and he didn't like just sitting around and being idle, so he got to work in his backyard. He started with the fishing pond over here, and then as we say, was hooked.
It's really amazing. So his family must have thought maybe he's a little crazy.
Well, I don't know. This is something that's happening quite a bit in this period. There's people creating these types of environments in their backyard. Today we might see it as a bit more unusual, but at the same time there was an individual here in Springfield creating totem poles and putting them in his yard. And there are other people kind of creating these environments. Maybe not to this scale, and they don't still exist today. But this is something that's happening across the country. Now maybe they did think he was crazy.
Sure.
But no, this is something that was quite popular at the time,
okay.
This kind of hobby. We're not too long out of the Great Depression. So
sure.
People, for the first time, really in a long time, had time on their hands. So they used that time by being creative. And that's certainly what Ben was doing. And if you think about it, he's a molder. He's working in a factory. He had very little opportunity in his life to be creative. So this is one of the first chances for him to express that creativity.
Yeah. Now, I see it's so very well maintained. How do you manage that?
It's all volunteers. It's a volunteer organization, the Friends of the Hartman Rock Garden. We have a couple benefactors that help offset our daily expenses out here. And that allows us to have volunteers doing a lot of the work, and any of the donations that come in go to the long-term care.
Now, because this is such a personal creation of one man, his family, are they still involved at all?
They are. They're very involved. So the family sold the garden, the site, to a group called the Kohler Foundation in Wisconsin. It's the same company you might know, Kohler,
yeah,
sinks, toilets. Yeah, they make tons and tons of products. And that company has a division or a foundation, a family foundation, that puts a lot of money behind the restoration of significant American folk art in visionary environments. This is also called a visionary environment. We like that term.
Yeah.
And they came out here and invested a good amount of money, time, resources to take this site back. It was deteriorating just over years of wear and tear. And then they donated the site to Springfield and this group that came together called the Friends of the Hartman Rock Garden. So we were very much divorced from the family and everything that had been as the initial creation and maintenance of the garden. But what's great is that family came back and said, what can we do to be involved? And they've been instrumental in that restoration process and in helping to fundraise and understanding the details. I mean, every single thing here, from what flowers are planted in this bed in front of us, the family has been able to help say, well, here's what we planted. Here's what we planted in the 40s. Here's what we planted in the 80s. We have a full visual record through photographs and oral testimony on how everything looked. And we try to keep up to those standards. We like to know that if there were pansies in a certain bed, we're going to try to continue putting pansies there. Because this is a rock garden, but it's really a flower garden that's accentuated, enhanced by the rock formations. So we think the flowers are as important to Ben's vision as his rock formations.
Thank you so much, Kevin, for sharing with us today.
Thank you.
We hope to see you on the trail then here at Hartman's.
Springfield may be the northern end of the Little Miami Scenic Trail, but it's the beginning of cycling opportunities in and around the city. You can see this trail has recently been improved. Springfield proudly promotes cycling, not only with legislation, but with other bike trails here, namely the Simon Kenton Trail and the Buck Creek Scenic Trail. There are dozens of bike racks all over the city, and businesses are choosing to cater to the cycling tourist.
Here we are in Springfield at the Old City Market, now home of the Clark County Heritage Center. This concludes our two-part series on the Little Miami Scenic Trail. I hope you enjoyed it. This trail has so much to do, so many places to see, that I think we could ride this trail a dozen times and not have to stop at the same place twice. I urge you to put this trail on your list and come ride just a section of it. If you found this video helpful, subscribe to us, and please share your feedback. If you'd like more information about this trail, click the link to pathpedler.com right there. We have thousands of trails to explore. Let us know what trails interest you. And I'll see you again on another episode of Path Pedler.